Using HDRIs to light our scenes look great, but you may have noticed that sometimes our 3D objects can look like they're floating. But now we can use dome mapping as our projection type, and this will make our ground flat and keep our objects in place. So in the next few minutes, we're going to take a look at how to use dome mapping to render an automotive shot just like this. So we already have a car in our scene from Chaos Cosmos. And I'm going to add a Corona Sky to our scene. And then we can create a disc. And we can make that 2000 centimeters. And this will act like a shadow catcher and will create shadows for our car so it looks grounded. Now we can open up the node material editor. Go to create, new material, and choose shadow catcher material. In here we can change the mode to environment and then drag our Corona Sky into the environment slot. We can change the projection mode to environment projection onto geometry and the alpha mode to always transparent. We can then apply this to our disk object. Now over in the Corona Sky, we can change the type to shader slash HDRI. And then we can load in our HDRI. And this one's called Small Hanger and it's available over on Polyhaven, and the link for that is in the description. Now let's go to the Corona menu and start an interactive render. And if you're following along, then this is the tone mapping that I've applied. So right now our car looks great, but it does look like it's floating, especially when I start moving around. As of Chaos Corona 8, we now have the option to choose dome as our projection map. And as soon as we select that, we can see that our ground has now flattened. And if we move around, we can see that the car stays grounded. To show you what's happening, if we make our radius 200 centimeters, we can see that the bottom of our HDRI is now flat. And as we make the radius bigger, we can see it begins to surround the car. Now the default for this is 2000 centimeters, and as with most things in Corona, this is going to work well most of the time. If we want to move the center point of our dome around, we can use the origin. And we can use the offset U to rotate our dome. And the camera height is how we dictate the height of the camera that shot the HDRI. So if you know the height of the camera when the HDRI was taken, you can add it here. If not, you're going to need to estimate. We can see as I bring this down, the edge of the dome gets distorted. So somewhere around the 200 centimeter mark looks good to me. And that's how we can use dome mapping in Cinema 4D to keep our objects grounded when using HDRIs to light our scenes. And if you like this video, then you may like to check out how to use Corona decals to project textures onto any object it's facing. Or alternatively, if you're interested in how to use the Corona slicer material, then you should check out this video where we break down how to easily cut through geometry.